Hello and welcome to a new video about pneumatics, about valve constructions. Last time we had this, we've seen a valve which has this symbol. And now I show you a valve which has this symbol and works a little bit different. This is how the valve looks like from the output. Look at that. Like said, again, it's not a construction. Again, it's just showing the principle. So we have the two connectors, one and two. One and two. And there must be three also somewhere. Yes, three is here on the other side. So now there's really a three connector. From the outside, there is again a push button. So this is the rod also there. Let's cut it open to see in the inside how it looks like. And here we see it looks a little bit different. So let's take a closer look. So right now, the one connector here, this goes into this room, and there is now also a seat, a puppet valve. It's seated here, and it's sealed. So, and also here there are ceilings. There is nothing much going on. Okay, so one is blocked, and what's with two? Here is three, here's two. Two is here and can here is connected to three. Good. This is what we expect from this. So now let's start to push the button. If we now push the button, start to push the button, then at some point in time, here, we are closing this. Book. Now it's closed. Now, two is sealed against three. Everything is sealed to each other. So, there is no overlapping. It's a valve without overlapping. Now it's sealed. And if we push the button further, we will open this seat here, and now what is happening? What is happening? One is now suddenly back connected to two, and three is sealed. This is the second. If we push it down up to the limit, down to the limit, then it looks like this. So one is now connected to two, and three is sealed. And if I now release it again, so this will go up until we are here closed. Update the springs. Now we are again sealed. Everything is sealed to each other. And this spring here now leads to the fact that this will also go up. Puck, until we reach here the final part. And now again, two is connected to three and one is sealed. That's it. So it is working exactly like the other one. So the symbol still the same. And now I show you, if we manufacture this inside here a little bit different, I'll just change this. Have you even noted what changed? Now one is not connected to here but down to here, and three is connected to the middle. Let's see how this looks like now. Now one, puck, is connected to two. Okay? If I push this down, puck, everything is locked. So it's also without overlapping. If I push it further, puck, one is now blocked. It is not going somewhere. And two is connected with three. So this now is a valve. It looks pretty much the same. Only the connectors are connected to another chamber inside there. And this now is a valve which has flow rest position. Because if we go back to our rest position, here, first step, everything is closed. And then go up to this part, we have a connection between one and two. So we have flow rest position. Okay, so this is the other valve. Yeah? The other possibility, let's call it. Yeah? First valve, same situation. Second valve, I show you also the symbol. Yeah? I show you the symbol. This was the old valve. The new valve I'm going to paint now in another color. So we also have two positions. We have to connect the 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, 3. We are again spring loaded. We are again rod operated. Yeah? But now in rest position we have flow. And 3 is blocked. And in the other position we would exhaust this, yeah? And 1 is blocked. If I again want to draw it, how it would look like as pushed, yeah? Looks like this. Two positions. The two positions are of course the same. There's still the spring, there's still the rod. Yeah? There's the connector 1, there's the connector 3, and there's the connector 2. And to show that it is pressed, I also have to draw this little thing here. So this is now the other variant. And as you have seen, the two variants are not that different. Let's have a look again here. This is the flow and this is the lock. Not much difference, right? Next time we will see a valve which can be operated by pressure, by air. Now we have operation by rod. Next time we will see how a valve looks like if we operate it by air. It will then be in next video. For this time, thank you very much for listening. Goodbye.